Welcome to our next video by Howard Piano Industries. Today we're going to be showing you the process of going through a piano action and doing what's called reconditioning. There are different terms that go around. You'll hear the term rebuilding, reconditioning, these types of things. Really what it is reconditioning is just going through the action, making sure all the parts work, you know, replacing maybe some of the felt pieces that may be worn, you know, and just making sure, you know, everything's in alignment and lubricated and everything so that the action works and performs well. If you hear the term rebuilding, that's a little more extensive. That means actually replacing, you know, worn action parts rather than just replacing felts. Replacing strings, hammers, you know, soundboard, pin block, that kind of thing in some instances, which would be a full rebuild. But today we're just going to be talking about going through the action and, you know, replacing some of the parts that are the most common to be worn, not going into hammer replacement and so forth, but you know, aligning things, lubricating things, making sure the action works as well as it can without going into extensive rebuilding procedures. Now, the process that I'm going to be going through is the process that you'll see in the book that we sell called Pianos Inside Out by Mario Igrek. It's a section in the book that goes through step by step how to go through the action and you know, go through a recondition and make sure that everything's working well. The first thing we're gonna have to do is you know, take the case parts off the piano, which I've done here. I've taken off the music desk and the fall board. If you look down here below, I've taken off the baseboard that goes up against where the pedals are. And I've taken off the key slip. So it gives us access to the different parts of the piano so that we can inspect things and do the work that's needed. Once you've done that, you're going to want to check the basic alignment, spacing, and condition of the action parts. You know, you want to look at the hammers. In general, these are pretty good. You can see right here that there's a little bit wider space, you know, in between these two. And as I go through these steps, I'm not going to explain the full procedure of how to do each thing, as we have other videos that go into more detail about that. So, you know, in another one of our videos, we'll talk about how to adjust the alignment and the spacing in the hammers and the whippins. You want to make sure the whippins, back checks, and everything are you know, aligned and spaced correctly. You know, you can, as you look at these back checks, you can see that some, there's a little bit wider space between them than others. You know, so we do have a video on adjusting the back checks so they work properly. But, you know, the big thing is the hammers, making sure that there's a good space between them and the whippins and all the action parts. The next thing you probably want to do is go through and vacuum, which we show you how to clean the inside of a piano in another one of our videos also. But vacuum out any old dust. You know, after we take the action out, you can lift all the keys out, and if you haven't been underneath the keys for a while, then you'll notice there's a lot of dust underneath them that's been built up over time. You want to check the condition of the pedals down here. Make sure that they work. You know, if you check them, you know, listen for extra noises. It should be fairly quiet. You know, you might hear creaking or clicking noises or clunking noises. If that's the case, it could mean that felts need replaced or something needs lubricated. But just generally check the condition of the pedals would be the next step. After that, you want to just double check the basic timing of the damper pedal lifting. Okay, and what that is is the dampers are back here, and what they do is they rest up against the strings, and as you push down the rightmost pedal of the three pedals, the one on the right, that will lift those dampers, okay? And it should be that you can push that damper pedal down just a little bit, slight amount, before the dampers start lifting. And you want to check the timing of the others, other pedals also. Now you want to check for some, again, pedal noises, like I mentioned, making sure that there's no extra noises that need to be addressed. The next step would be lubricating the key pins. Okay, underneath each key, you've got a balance rail pin and a front rail pin. So you want to make sure that those are lubricated well so that the key can go up and down freely without having, you know, if there's corrosion or if the pin is too tight and if there's a bushing that that lines the hole that those pins goes through, if those bushings are too tight, that you want to make sure that that those keys work up and down freely. So that would be the next step, is easing and lubricating the key bushings. Okay, which we've shown in another one of our videos, is putting some PTFE powder there on those bushings, so that those you know, there's not extra friction there, which will make the action harder to play. And the next step in the reconditioning process is going through and regulating the keyboard, okay, making sure that all the keys are level, which we do have another video on key leveling. You want to make sure that the key dip is correct, okay, and you know, part of this is going through part of this is going to be done in the regulating process, which is done after you do all the reconditioning. Regulating is adjusting all the action parts so that they play well. Okay, and that's done after you make sure everything is in good working order. But you want to regulate that keyboard, which you want to kind of get a general, a basic regulation first, so that it works fairly well before we do the fine regulation after all the rest of the reconditioning is done. The next thing is the bridle straps, okay, which are these straps right here. They hook onto a bridle wire at the end of the, which is a little pointy wire at the end of the whippin. And if any of those are broken or they're unhooked, you want to make sure you take note of that, because if they're broken and you take the action out, if that bridle strap isn't there to hold that whippin up, you could break jacks or other action parts as you go to put the action back into the piano. So you want to make sure you notice if you're going to have to do any of that work as you take the action out before you put the action back in, so that if those bridle straps need replaced or need adjusted, make sure that they're hooked onto the bridle wire before you take that out if they're unhooked. The next thing is to check your jack springs. Now, you can't see it very well, but right in here there's a jack spring. I'm going to pull out a whip in here to show you. This piece would be right in here. Okay, so here you've got there, and that's how that would sit. Okay, and right here, okay, I'll go through the basic parts of the whippin. Okay, this is the whippin body right here. This is your bridle wire, okay, and so your bridle strap is gonna hook onto that. This is your back check right here, back check wire. This right here, you can see it is the jack spring. Okay, so there's a spring in there that the jack makes it go back and forth. So so then, of course, this piece right here is your jack. This is the jack flange right here, and then back here is the whippin flange right there. So that's your whippin flange. Okay, so you've got those different parts. So you want to check your jack springs, make sure that they're in place and that they sit in the whippin and jack notches. You know, there's a little notch down here at the bottom for the bottom of the jack spring to sit in. You want to make sure that the top of it, as you can see, there's a, on the bottom of the jack, there's a little slot for the top of the jack spring to go into. So you want to make sure those are all in place. You know, if possible, that some of the jack springs might be weak or worn or broken. or out of place, you know, then you'll want to make sure that you go through and replace. You know, sometimes it's a good idea when you're reconditioning just to replace all the jack springs, because over time they do get worn and they can make noises and so forth. So making sure if it's not working, you know, as like it should, you can stretch it out a little bit so it'll be a little more springy and give a little bit more spring to the jack. The next thing you want to check are the back checks and the catchers. Again, here this piece right here is the back check. You want to check to see if that felt is worn. Okay, going back to our whipping here. Here we've got our back check. If this felt right here is worn, you'll want to replace that, and that's a real easy felt to place or replace. So that's another thing. The catcher, okay, I'm going to take over here. Here we've got this is your hammer butt, okay, and the bridle strap that we talked about, that's attached to the hammer butt. Okay, here I've got a hammer butt. Here we've got our bridle strap right here. And so this piece right here is what's called the catcher, and on the outside of that is a leather, okay, or buckskin or whatever you want to call it. And what that does is as the note is played, the back check catches on the catcher. Okay, so the back check catches on the catcher, and this leather right here can get worn. So if it looks like there's indentation in it, of course this is a new one, so it looks nice and smooth. But a piano that's been played a lot, you'll notice that the outside edges of this leather will be protruding more out from the inside, and that's because the inside of the leather's been packed, compacted down and worn down. So if you find that that's the case, you want to replace that catcher leather so that you've got a nice contact there. So again, the back check felt and the catcher leather, you want to check those to make sure that those are in good condition, or replace it if you need to. The next thing you want to do is you want to tighten the hammer butt screws. So in the hammer, you know, this one's a little bit different. It doesn't have this one's made for brass flange, but most of them have a wood flange on it. And so back in here, you'll see a flange that's attached to the bottom of the hammer butt. And there's a screw going into that, into a rail that's attached to the whole action. So you want to go through the whole action, and every one of those hammer butt screws you want to tighten. So what you'll do is with one finger with another screwdriver, you'll push down on the toe of the jack. Okay, the toe of the jack is this right here. Okay, so if you push down on that to bring it forward, then you have better access to the hammer butt screw. So push down on that, and then take a long thin blade screwdriver, and tighten that screw up. Okay, and do that on all 88 of the hammer butts. Then the other thing you want to check, the next thing you want to check, is make sure that the whippings are sitting squarely on the capstans. You want to make sure that they're centered under the capstans are centered under the hammer butts. Okay, and you know, if they're not, you know, again, in another video we'll show you how to make the adjustments on that. It's called traveling the whipping, so we'll show you that in another video. But you want to check that to make sure everything's square and that's part of the alignment. You want to check your damper felts, okay? The dampers back here, they've got felt pieces that rest up against the strings. If the damper felts are missing, or if they've gotten hard over time, what you can do is as you lift or press on the damper pedal and lift those dampers, if if they make kind of a zinging noise as the damper felt comes back and rests against the strings, that means that felt has probably gotten some hard spots in it. What you can do is you can take a very, very lightly take a brass bristle brush and rub on that damper felt a little bit to take some of that hard spot off. Sometimes you can needle the felt. those are some things you can do to make it so that you get rid of that zinging noise, extraneous noise that that pianos can get over time. The next step you want to check are the damper blocks. Okay, now you can't see it, but there are blocks that a screw goes through that holds that block to a damper wire. And then the felt is attached to that. So you want to make sure those screws for the damper blocks are nice and tight and that the blocks are aligned correctly. And so go through the whole dampers, all the dampers, and tighten those screws, making sure those are nice and tight. Then what we're going to do, the next step we're going to do, so those are all the things to check while the action is inside the piano. The next portion of the video is we're going to be taking the action out and checking some things with the action outside of the piano. As you can see here, we've removed the action from the piano, which we show you how to do that in another one of our videos, but here we can just see that the keys are remaining. And what you can do is, at this point, you can go through and lift out all the keys out of the piano, take them all out, and vacuum underneath the keys. Here you want to inspect the keys. Again, we want to check to see if these bushings need replaced. You know, we talked about lubricating those, but if they need to be replaced, you do that at this point. And then you also want to check here. We've got the capstan. Okay, the capstan is it's got a piece at the bottom, and that pushes up on the bottom of the whip. And you want to go through and polish those. You know, we talked about polishing the key pins. That's real important. But polishing those capstans so that there's not any excess friction in there. You can do that. You want to check your key tops too. You know, if the key tops are in bad condition, you want to go through and replace those if needed. We have a number of different options for key tops that you can do, and we have a video on how to replace the key tops. Check the sharps if they need. Sometimes they're worn and need to be refinished. You can refinish the sharps, or you can replace them with new plastic or wood sharps. That's the keyboard. Then over here we have the action, which we've taken out of the piano, and we've got it sitting. I've actually got it in an action cradle, which we show how to use those, which is some stands on that go on each end of the action to hold it up in place so that you can more easily access those. And we show how to use that if you want to use that. Now the next thing you want to do is check your hammer butt leathers and felts. Okay, here we've got these are the hammer butts right here. They're attached to the hammer shank, which then attaches to the hammer up on the top. Okay, here we've got a close up of a hammer butt. Again, we talked about this being the catcher and the catcher leather, but right here we've got the hammer butt leather. And then the felt on the bottom. Sometimes there's, and this one there actually is a thin piece of felt behind the leather. You know, you can replace that, but here we've got the hammer butt felt and the hammer butt leather. So if that is worn, if you've got a worn compressed spot from the jack pushing up on that, you want to replace that hammer butt leather. Okay, so that's checking that to the felts and the leathers. Here's another piece of felt that you want to check for that being worn. You can replace that. Again, it's just a little piece of felt. square. Now the best glue to use for any of these felts or leathers is PVC e-glue, okay, which we have available in our store. It's not something you can usually get locally in a local store, but we've got it available in our online store. You can get it from most of the piano supply companies. Gluing those on, the PVC glue is good as with the felt and any of the leathers. Then what you're going to want to do is brush and lubricate the whip and heel felts. We show how to do that with PTFE powder. You'll put a little bit of powder in there and then burnish it in with something metal or brass. And then you want to go through and check your bridle straps, okay? We talked about earlier in the video how if they were broken or unhooked or anything, you want to make sure that you go through and that all of the whippings, if you've got an unhooked bridle strap or if it was broken, the whipping would hang down like this, okay? Whereas all of these are being held up by these bridle straps, okay? So, and you'll notice that with the action out of the piano and the whipping being able to fall down this far, if I push up on this, okay, you probably can't see it, but it's not falling underneath the hammer butt. It's actually pushing up on the hammer butt felt so that when you would go to put that back in the action, the hammer is going to push up against the string, and you're actually could risk breaking something in the action if that bridle strap isn't there holding the whipping up in place. Okay, so it's very real important to make sure that your bridle straps are hooked on, you know, not broken and intact, so that all your whippings are up, so that your jacks are in front of the hammer butt felt when you go to put the action back in the piano. So sometimes you might have to adjust these bridle wires a little bit. Okay, ideally what you want to have is a distance from a quarter inch to 3/8 inch between the top of the jack and the hammer butt leather. Okay, so you want to have about a quarter inch to 3/8 inch distance there. You know, the exact distance isn't super crucial, just making sure that it's consistent. You know, and that is adjusted by these bridle wires, okay, which can be bent forward or backwards to make the bridle strap, you know, so that it, you know, bring the whipping further up or further down. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is go through the whole action and tighten all the frame screws. Okay, you've got screws here, along there, and go through and whatever screws are holding the action together, you want to make sure that you tighten those up, because they can loosen up over time. Earlier we went through and adjusted or tightened up all of the hammer butt screws or hammer flange screws. Then you want to go through and inspect the other felts and cloths. Okay, here we've got back here that the hammer shanks rest on is the hammer rail cloth. That oftentimes needs replaced as hammers get played and the shanks fall back onto that felt. Okay, you're going to get it worn and it can become compacted and need to be replaced. We show in another one of our videos how to replace that. You want to check your regulating punchings, which is a piece of felt that the toe of the jack goes up against when the note is played. Those are often compacted and has a worn spot in it, so you want to check those. We'll show you in another video how to replace those felts. You want to check the whip and heel cloth, which here we can do is I'm just going to turn the action up a little bit here. Okay, so down here, that this piece that sits right on top of the capstan is a felt piece. We use action cloth for that. So you want to kind of check the thickness, and if that's got a divot in it like these do, then you want to replace that action cloth with new felt. So go through and double check the condition of your felts. You may want to replace damper felts, if they're worn. Okay, and the next is you want to check the condition of your hammers. Okay, oftentimes if a piano has been played a lot and it's had many years of use, been heavily played, you're going to see grooves in the face of the hammer, so that where the strings hit. Okay, so you want to go through and reshape that felt. If you've got really, really deep grooves, you're going to want to make that so that those grooves are come down and not so deep. And even in some cases, you might want to make it smooth, and you just don't want to flatten it. Okay, if you just file it flat, straight up and down, you're going to have a flat spot, which is going to take away the basic shape of the hammer. Okay, and we'll talk some more about reshaping hammers and voicing and so forth in other videos. But you want to check the shape of those hammers and make sure that they're shaped well. And we want to check the hammer butt center pins. Okay, again, here we've got a hammer butt. This one's a close up. Here we've got one with a flange on it. If that hammer butt, if that center pin that goes through the flange and through the hammer butt is tight in the flange, the hammer is going to be sluggish. So as you push it up, okay, you want to see if that hammer falls back quickly. Okay, and it should. The one reason that it might not is if your hammer butt spring is out of place. Okay, there's springs back here that help the hammer to return. If that spring is broken or if it's out of place, the spring comes up and sits in a groove inside the hammer butt. If that spring has fallen out of the groove, then here we've got the groove right here. If that spring has fallen out of the groove, then you just lift it and push it back and put it back into the groove, and that could be the cause. But if the spring is in place and it's not broken, and the hammer butt is still slow to return, it could be that this center pin, the flange, is too tight. Okay, and so you want to go through and either use some Protex CLP or some other lubricant, or repin it if necessary, by reaming out the flange bushing slightly to get it to the right tightness. And we have another one of our videos that shows how to take care of the tight flange. If the flange is too loose, okay, you want to check here. Okay, as long as your hammer butt or hammer flange screws are tight, you come up here and you kind of push back and forth, you'll feel a little bit of wiggling. But if you feel any looseness in that would mean that the pin is too loose in the hole, okay, because you don't want this to wobble back and forth inside the flange, okay, because that can make noises and it can cause premature wear on your parts and your hammers and so forth. So if that's too loose, then you can go through and put a larger pin in it, making sure that it still moves freely, but it's not too loose, or it could be loose in the hammer butt itself. Okay, so you want to double check that. And again, in that video that we have about checking and fixing loose or tight flanges, we can go through the process of how to get the right tightness for those. Then you're going to check the whippin. The center pin for the whippin, and what that is we showed you here the whippin, and back here is the whippin flange. Okay, so again, there's a pin that goes through that, and if that flange is too loose or too tight, the same kind of thing. Okay, if you can go come over here and you wiggle that, okay, the one thing you want to do is before you do that is make sure that all your whip and flange screws are tight, okay? You can't see it because it's all the way in the back, but back here there's screws, okay, and that would go through this hole right here in the flange, okay, and just so tighten all those screws so that the whippin is tight and at least the screw is tight. But if once you've done that and you come through here and this wiggles a little bit, okay, if you feel movement, that means this pin is too loose, okay, or it could be too tight. Okay, if you go through here and you lift up on this and it doesn't move freely, you know, then that means this is too tight. You could take a couple of the whippins out and check the tightness of the flange, you know, with either a gram gauge or you know, if you can kind of get a general idea. If you go like this and you learn how to get a feel for it, you know, if you feel quite a bit of you know, friction or resistance, then you know it could be that it's too light or too tight. And there again, using Protex CLP or reaming and repinning is the solution to that. The other thing is the jack center pin. Okay, one common cause for sluggish keys is a tight center pin on the jack flange. Okay, so that's the same kind of thing there. Okay, if you don't want it to be wobbly, okay, this should still be tight. The action part should still be tight in the flange. But if it's too tight, you know, then this isn't gonna move freely. So you want to take it out of the, or take it off of the spring, and check to see how that feels. Okay, you can check it with a gram gauge. Again, you know, it should be about 3 to 4 grams, somewhere in that range without the spring on it. Okay, so you want to check that that tightness. But those are some things to check. Those are commonly needed items of attention when you're going through this process. The next thing is we talked about making sure your whippins are aligned, okay, and that they travel pretty much straight up and down. Okay, if they don't, you'll need to adjust that, and we'll talk about that in another video. And we talked about tightening the whip and flange screws. You want to check that before you check the center pin tightness. If the hammer butts are like this, where they've got, and this one doesn't have it, but if it's got where these sit in a like a brass plate, some pianos have that. Some of the older uprights have a brass hammer flange. You want to make sure those flanges are tight. Don't over tighten them because they can break, because over time they can get a little bit brittle. And you want to check if they are brittle. You may need to replace those because that's often the case on an older piano. And then your jack, make sure these jack flanges are tight in the whip and base. Okay, so you want to check the tightness of those and make sure they're nice and firm in there. Sometimes those will come unglued or they may be a little wobbly. If so, just take the jack flange out, put some glue in there and glue it back in. If it's cracked or broken or anything like that, you can replace that with a new jack flange. The hammer butt springs often will get worn. They might get some oxidation, and they get a little bit noisy. Again, you can't see the hammer butt spring, but it comes back here behind the hammer butt. Okay, so here we've got our catcher. If we turn that around, the slot for the hammer butt spring is right in here, and sometimes this slot is lined with felt, but spring, if it's, you know, rough feeling because of oxidation over time, you may want to replace the springs, or you can sometimes smooth them out by polishing them a little bit. So you want to check those to make sure that they are in good condition. Here we've got the action turned back around so that you can see the back of it. Here we've got the damper felts. These are the damper levers. Here's the face of the hammers. I don't know if you can see this in the video, but there are some light string marks, okay, small grooves in these hammers, which can be filed out with a sandpaper file. But here we're showing the dampers. Next thing you want to check is the damper lift rod. Okay, so over here we've got the rod that would be pushed up by the pedal rod, and what that does is that lifts all of these dampers. Okay, so you want to make sure all those dampers are lifting evenly. If one section is lifting earlier or later than the rest, you may have to make some repairs to that or adjustments, which we'll talk about in another one of our videos. If you hear creaking or clicking or anything like that, it could be that you need to put some lubrication here in the points where the damper rod attaches to the action frame. We usually got some pivots there. The other thing you want to check, the next thing you want to check here are the damper spoons. Okay, here I've got another upright whip in here. This one's a little bit bigger for a larger piano, but it shows the damper spoon, and what that is this pushes on the back of the damper lever. Okay, so that when the whipping goes. Moves, okay, and what that does is this pushes against the damper lever, which raises the damper, okay, and that's what makes the damper. So part of the regulation procedure is going to be adjusting those to the right height, but you want to go through and make sure that it's not corroded. If the plating is chipping off, that you might want to replace those spoons. Or it could be that if they're corroded, you can polish them, put a little bit of dry film lubricant on it, like Pro-Tec CL or Pro-Tec Pro Lube, on that to make it so that it glides smoothly. You want to check the condition of the damper felts, damper lever felts, I should say. Those are back here, and they go up against the back of the spoon. So if those are worn or hardened or whatever, you want to replace those felts as well. So that's another felt you can check, which often needs replaced. You want to check to see that the springs are nice and tight. Sometimes they need tightened, sometimes those springs need replaced. You could just replace the flanges, or you could replace the whole damper lever. Which is in some cases helpful, but if we're just reconditioning, sometimes just making sure those damper springs are working properly. If they've got sometimes they're a little noisy if they've gotten some oxidation or corrosion on them, and just cleaning those up, and again putting. They rust up against a notch in the back of the damper, and so sometimes just putting some lubrication back in there will help that too. Then you want to go through and put the action back in the piano, and then you'll be ready to regulate the whole thing. So that's going through the entire process of at least most of the major things to check in reconditioning piano. There are other things more extensive, then it gets into rebuilding. Again, you can replace hammers if they're really worn, if it's a really, really old piano that's had a lot of use. Sometimes the hammers need replaced. You can replace strings. You can go through and start replacing action parts if they're really worn. But, if it's a piano that's, not had a ton of use over its life and it just needs some basic reconditioning to bring it back to where it needs to be, these are the steps to go through and check, some of the things to check before going through and regulating the piano to get it to work the best that it can. Now, if you have any questions, feel free to visit our website. It's howardpianoindustries.com.